You clicked on this so you could find out 10 foods that you could eat after having your wisdom teeth removed. Well, I can definitely help you with that. I just had my wisdom teeth removed about a week ago. Let's get to 10 foods that you can eat after having your wisdom teeth removed. First on the list, and a good choice, that way you don't fall behind nutritionally and make sure your body's up to nutritional standards, is nutrition shakes. So whether that be Ensure, your local market's version, Walmart's version, Slim Fast, Atkins diet, drink some nutritional shakes. It'll definitely help out in recovery, and it's easy, and the best thing about it is if you put them in a fridge and drink them cold, it actually will soothe your days 1 through 3. You have a couple of shakes on deck, whether it's for breakfast or before you go to bed or throughout the day. Second on the list, we have one of my favorites when I had my wisdom teeth removed that week of, is yogurt. Whether it's low fat yogurt, Greek yogurt, but make sure it does not have any fruits that have little seeds in them. So you can have flavored yogurt, but make sure it doesn't have any fruit particles in it, specifically small seeds, so such as strawberries or raspberries, any of those small seeds that may get stuck in your wounds, you don't want that. But my favorite was just plain Activia vanilla yogurt. That was probably my sweet treat during my time going through recovery. Number three, on the flip side of yogurt, I'm gonna pull them together, but we're gonna say pudding and jell-o. This can be a sweet treat for you if you're into sweets. Also, if you refrigerate them and have them cooler, it's really good on the back of the throat, you know, days 1 through 3, when it's very tender and sore and you really don't even wanna bite down on gauze, but it'll feel good. So pudding and jell-o. Number four on the list, this was a personal favorite of mine the first 2 days, mashed potatoes. Whether they're real mashed potatoes and you cook them down, add the water or milk into it to really make them creamy, or you get these ones, your powdered potatoes, clutch. Just make sure they're creamy enough. You don't want to chew at all. You just want to make sure that you enjoy without making it more painful for yourself. Five on the list is pasta, but more specifically, overcooking your pasta. And what kind of pasta? Ones that don't have vegetables or a bunch of different particles in them, but you can stick to something like Kraft mac and cheese, or what I also ate was pasta sides. Pasta like that is perfectly fine. Just make sure you overcook it a little bit. That way you don't run into any chance of hurting your wounds there in the back if you don't cook it properly. If you're a breakfast lover, you'll like this because you can still eat scrambled eggs. Now what you put in the eggs may be limited to what you're used to, but you can still cook up your favorite scrambled eggs with your favorite limited seasonings in there. Remember, not too spicy. You shouldn't be eating any spicy food. Your eggs may be a little bland than usual, but at least you can still get away with one of your favorite breakfast dishes. Number seven on the list is applesauce. And you can have different flavored applesauces. So as you know, they have the raspberry or strawberry applesauce. Most of those don't have those little food seeds or particles in them, so you'll be good with that. You probably want to put it in the fridge to cool it down. That way it kind of soothes your throat back there and all the irritation and swelling. It kind of helps out with that on the side. Number eight on the list, you guys are probably waiting for this one, but smoothies. You can have smoothies. Watch out on what content you put in the smoothies and make sure you blend it up. So you can have your favorite smoothies, whether it's a protein infused smoothie with kale, spinach. If you do put fruits in it, make sure that there aren't little seeds. Make sure your smoothies are actually smooth and there's nothing that can get irritated or trapped in your wisdom teeth wounds. Ninth on the list, we have soup. Soups and different broths. You can get away with chicken noodle soup, overcook the noodles, shred the chicken down as much as you can. Remember, you're trying to limit any particles getting in your wounds. It's pretty repetitive in this video, but that's for a reason. I actually on day 4 was eating a couple of different chunky soups with vegetables that I could overcook within the soup, and I knew they wouldn't give me any issues. So you can get away with quite a bit of soup. And then last on the list is peanut butter. You have to make sure you get the smooth peanut butter, not the peanut butter with the chunks in it. So peanut butter is a good little treat that you can have. Watch out how much you put in there, because we know if you get peanut butter stuck on the roof of your mouth, you have to maneuver around, and that may agitate some of your wounds. So maybe save peanut butter for the later days. Maybe don't eat it in days 1 through 3. In my experience, I only had a little bit of peanut butter, and that was in my 3rd and 4th day. So I stayed away from any chance of just irritating my wounds in days 1 to 2. So days 1 to 2, I really just ate mashed potatoes, a little bit of overcooked pasta, and I mean overcooked mac and cheese. We're talking about mac and cheese that you wouldn't eat if you weren't in this situation. Please like and share with anyone else who may be going through wisdom tooth surgery soon. Check out my channel, subscribe, and if you're going through wisdom tooth surgery, I wish you the best. Everything will be fine. Just remember, get ready for what you can eat, and most importantly, rest. Wish you the best of luck. It's AJ Carver here. Till next time, we out.